the Canelo versus Smith Liam Smith Media Conference Call. My name is Christine, and I will be the operator for today's call. At this time, all participants are in a listen-only mode. Later, we will conduct a question-and-answer session. If you have a question, please press star then one on your touch-tone phone. Please note that this conference is being recorded. I will now turn the call over to Eric Gomez, Senior Vice President of Golden Boys Promotion. You may begin.
Thank you very much. We're very excited to be on this call. We're just 2 weeks away from the show. This is the official international media conference call with WBO Junior Middleweight World Champion, undefeated champion, Liam Beefy Smith. On September 17th, over Mexican Independence Weekend, Canelo returns to Texas for a big challenge, a dangerous challenge, in WBO World Champion, Liam Beefy Smith. Obviously, it's going to be at AT&T Stadium, home of America's team, the Dallas Cowboys. Canelo's going to be returning for the first time to Texas, where last he had a great fight against James Kirkland. So we're very excited about that. Liam, as you know, is undefeated. He's known as a heavy puncher. He's coming off a streak of 8 knockouts in a row. He's probably the toughest test that Canelo's ever had. So it's going to be a great night of boxing, and it's going to be a great fight. Just like we say, everything's bigger in Texas. The stadium is doing very well with ticket sales. We're already over 25,000 in ticket sales. There's still tickets available. You can buy tickets at Ticketmaster. You can go on the website, www.ticketmaster.com, or you can call by phone at 1-800-745-3000. Tickets are as low as $40 and $750 for ringside. So now I want to turn it over to our co-promoter for the fight and good friend Frank Warren to introduce the team. Frank?
Thank you, Eric. Very kind of you. It's obviously a great privilege to be working on such a special show in Dallas on the 17th of September. Liam Smith, I've promoted since he turned professional 8 years ago. I've always thought that he was an exceptional fighter, an exceptional British fighter. He's won all his fights today. He's on a 8-fight knockout roll. And I've never seen him up so much for a fight. He begged me for this fight, and we've made it happen between all of us. And I can assure you, when he gets there on the 17th, there's going to be some serious fireworks in Dallas. It's going to be a real celebration for the Brits. It might be Mexican Independence Day, but it's going to be the Brits are coming, and the Brits are going to come away still holding that belt. He is so confident, and as all the time I've known him, I've never felt or doubted him, his ability. And he's one of those fighters, the bigger the occasion, the more you'll get out of him. He's 28 years of age. He comes from Liverpool. He's the first Liverpool world champion to come out of Liverpool in 22 years. He comes from a fighting family. His brothers are all professional boxers, all very successful. And I think he is the best out of the brothers. I've always said that and feel that he is. And I'm quite sure we're going to see something special in Dallas on the 17th. Liam's on the line, and I know you'd like to speak to him. So, Liam, over to you.
Yeah, thanks, Frank. As you say, all the fight here now, it's 2 weeks away. We've done a lot of the hard work already. You know, we've got a couple of more hard sessions left, and then it's all about getting down, getting the timing right towards the 17th. Me and Joe, we've had a good camp. We'll come prepared, and like Frank said, it's a fight I've always asked for. I've been on Frank's case for this fight and a number of fights of this magnitude for over 12 months now, and like I say, no one can come to me and say I'm not at Canelo's level, because they don't know that, because they haven't performed at that level yet. This fight is going to tell you guys that I'm at that level. You know, it's not going to tell myself, because I know I can perform at that level, and Okay, you will know William Smith has come September 17th.
That's great. That's great. Thank you, Liam. Thank you, and Frank. Thank you for the kind words. So, a couple of notes before we open up for questions. Obviously, this is going to be brought to you. This fight is going to be brought to you by HBO Pay-Per-View. So, if you can't be there in person, make sure you get the pay-per-view. And last but not least, I'd like to thank our sponsors involved in this fight: Tecate, Born Bold, O'Reilly Auto Parts, Hennessy, Never Stop, Never Settle, Adriano's Insurance, AT&T, Mobilizing Your World, and Casa Mexico Tequila. So with that, thank you to the sponsors. We couldn't be able to put together a great show like this without you. So with that, we can open up for questions.
Thank you. We will now begin the question-answer session. If you have a question, please press star then one on your touch-tone phone. If you wish to be removed from the queue, please press the pound sign or the hash key. If you are using a speakerphone, you may need to pick up the handset first before pressing the numbers. Once again, if you have a question, please press star, then one on your touch-tone phone. Our first question comes from Dan Raphael from ESPN. Please go ahead.
Thank you very much. Hello, Frank and Liam. How are you guys today?
Fine, thanks, Dan. Hope you're well.
Great. Hey, Liam,
I'm just letting you know I'm here in the room. Joe Gallagher as well, just to let you know. I wasn't introduced.
Joe, sorry.
Sorry.
Oh, hey, Joe.
No problem, Dan.
That's entirely down to me. Joe Gallagher, obviously, is on the line. Ring trainer of the year 2015, and he's done a fantastic job with Liam, working with him over the years. And you know, I can't say enough as to his ability in doing so. I do apologize.
No problem.
Okay. Joe, it's good to have you on the call also. My first question, Liam, my question for you is a lot of your British countrymen have, you know, talked a lot during their careers about how they wanted to come to the United States and fight. I remember hearing those comments from Ricky Hatton and, you know, from Joe Calzaghe and people like that that really look forward at some point in their career to making a name for them. They had made their name in Britain, but they wanted to have bigger fights in the United States. Obviously, you have a big fight here now with Canelo Alvarez, but I'm wondering, and it's going to be your first fight in the United States, I'm wondering, has one of your goals been sort of like what those guys talked about, that you really wanted to come to the States and make a big name for yourself, or was it just sort of the way it worked out for you? And what are your feelings about having an opportunity to fight in the United States?
This fight, it's got nothing really to do with any of other than fighters you've mentioned, Dan. It also doesn't reflect on any of the fighters you've challenged. Canelo is in, Matthew Atten, Ryan Rose, and Amir Khan. This is to do with me, and, you know, it's a personal thing for me. I've always been told, you know, I think I've got a style that the American fight fans will like. You know, there's no messing up with my style. There's no awkwardness. There's no holding. There's no negativity around me. You know, what you see is what you get. I'm coming to fight. And like I said to you last time on the phone, Dan, mark my words, I'm coming to fight September, and you are going to be in for a massive shock. But this fight, again, is to do with me and making a name for myself over your end and establishing myself to the world of boxing, you know, not just the British fight fans.
But was it your goal, though, to fight in America like some of your past star countrymen? Was that like a big, like on your bucket list?
No, I don't want to emulate any of them, Dan. I want to go to beat Canelo and make me own, get people talking about Liam Smith, not Richie Hatton. Richie Hatton is a great fighter, Joe Calzaghe is a great fighter, but I don't want to.
No, Liam, I think you're misunderstanding me. I understand what you're saying. I'm wondering, was in your mind, when you became a professional fighter and started to make your way up the ranks, was fighting a major fight in the States a big deal for you? Is that something you aspired to do?
Yeah, it is. It is, Sandy. You know, if you ask anyone on the line, I go to the States, you know, twice, three times a year, training and sparring. I explained that last time, the amount of teams I've been over in the States, the Wildcard Gym, the Rock Gym, Boxing Burn, Gushin's Gym. I went to Razor Hunter's Gym to spar in here for the Canelo fight. You know, I've been in numerous gyms in the States, and you know, probably if I didn't have the bonds with Joe and I didn't have the relationship with Frank as a promotional company, I'd have probably moved to America a long time ago. But, you know, I've got two of the bond with them to basically to jump ship and move there. But you know, I've got, I'd love to meet there when I finish boxing, to be honest with you, Dan. I love the States, and to make a name out there for myself is something I've always wanted to do.
Okay, my other question for you is, a lot of the conversation that's been directed towards Canelo going to this fight is, you know, why he's not fighting Gennady Golovkin, who's coming to your country next week to fight Kell Brook, and the fight that many people in the United States had hoped to see was Canelo fighting against Golovkin. So my question for you is, how tired of that are you hearing about how people are disappointed that Canelo is not fighting Triple G and that he's fighting this guy Liam Smith, who most people here never heard of. Does it make a difference to you? Does it motivate you? Like, what's your point to all the people that say they don't know who Liam Smith is and we'd rather see him be fighting Triple G?
Yeah, I don't knock the people saying we don't know Liam Smith is. I knock the people who are being critical towards me, Dan, and all I ask of them is make sure you come back on to the same social media, to the same magazine which you criticise, and make sure you come back on September the 18th and, you know, hold your hands up and say you were wrong. I don't mind. Anyone who doesn't know me, I can't blame them. I haven't fought in the States just yet. I could have done what the fighters who you mentioned before, the way they've done it. Ricky Hatton went there and fought Castillo, you know, and then he went there and fought Juan Yango before he had his big fight against Mayor de Pacquiao. Now, I was just going to ask you the same thing, Dan. Do you know if I went there and fought UC Smith or I went there and fought one of the Charlo brothers? I think he'd probably be saying it's a very, very good fight. But it's just the fact I'm going there and I'm fighting the biggest name over there. They expected to fight Triple G. So I'm getting the backlash of that. But the thing, okay, you've got to know me as a person to know me if that ever give a shit about that. And I don't personally. You can talk what you want about, you know, Triple G and Canelo. But, you know, after September, there won't be no talk of Triple G with Canelo.
All right. Appreciate that. Liam, good luck. I'll see you in Dallas. Thank you. Thank you, Frank.
Thanks, Dan.
Thank you.
And Joe.
Thank you,
guys.
Thanks.
Thank you. Our next question comes from Mike Kattinger from USA Today. Please go ahead.
Hi, Liam. How's everything? Sorry, I'm on mute. Sorry. hi, Liam. How's everything going?
It's going very good. It's very good.
All right. My question for you is, you know, both your brothers, Paul and Steven, have fought only one time in the United States in, you know, big step-up fights, and neither one was competitive at all. And I wanted to know if you feel a pressure to, you know, end that streak, and if they've given you, and if they've given you any, you know, words of advice from their failures.
No, I don't feel any pressure that the brothers have been to the States and lost, you know, Dave. Paul fought a special fight in Andre Ward, and, you know, Stephen fought a very good Jose Pedraza on the night. I think if any other Jose Pedraza turns up, Stephen would have won that fight. I don't think Stephen performed bad. The occasion never got to Stephen. He just come up against a very good Pedraza. Now, the same, that's only going to give me confidence. I feel as if I've been in the States and fought before. You know, how close family we are, and how nervous I guess for my brothers. I already feel as if I've been in the States. You know, when I'm in that changing room, I feel as if I've been in the situation before. Obviously, I'm going to have to deal with it's a bigger stage than that. You know, this is the biggest stage. You know, it's the biggest stage in boxing. You know what I mean? It's the Dallas Cowboys AT&T Stadium. So, you know, no, that won't faze me. It's one I'm looking forward to finishing.
You got to bear in mind, that question you asked, it's a fair question you asked. However, Liam's going there as a world champion. His brothers didn't go there as world champion. He is a world champion. He's the brother that's won the world title.
I know, but I don't think that really means a whole lot in this day and age of four titles per weight class and everything. I mean, Canelo's the name here. He's the A side. Does that really make a big difference?
Well, it might not mean nothing to you, but I think it means something to Liam. He's actually very proud of being a world champion, and he's going there to defend his title. And obviously it has a value as a world title because that's why he's fighting Canelo. But the bottom line of it is that, as you said earlier, as far as going to the States, if you ask anybody of all the gyms that when he's gone and worked out there, all the guys he spar with, they'll tell you how good he is. He's a good fighter. You know, I've been involved with lots of fighters over the years. Lots of fighters gone out to the States. A lot of fighters I've been involved with have been considered to be no-hopers against great American fighters, or worse, to be great American fighters at the time. And a lot of my guys have won those fights. And I feel confident in Liam that he can emulate what they've done. And you'll be talking afterwards about when is Liam going to be fighting Golovkin, because that's what they're going to be talking about after this fight.
Okay, can you give me an example of maybe this fight that this reminds you of then? Of a past fighter, a guy you had who's considered, you know, not to have a shot?
I think with top of my head, Joe Calzaghe, once, you know, Showtime and everybody was building up Jeff Lacey
sure.
to be the next big thing, he yeah. destroyed him. I mean, absolutely mm-hmm. destroyed him. I can think of even Joe going out fighting Bernard Hopkins. He was an underdog in the fight, and he won that fight, and well won it. I thought the scoring was poor, and he well won that fight. When Frank Bruno was against Oliver McCall, knocked out Lennox Lewis, Frank Bruno was considered to be a no-hoper, and he won that fight. And there's quite a few of them. Nassim Hamid winning fights against over the years against American opponents that we brought over who were champions, won them all. He's of that ilk. He comes to fight. He can fight, and we call him. We call Liam the Scouse Mexican. Scouse is obviously, you might not know, is a Liverpool nickname, and Mexican
okay.
is how he fights.
And Liam, can you speak to that point that, you know, about how actually you are the champion when your brothers weren't, and how that might change things? The mindset that you're going to bring can you maybe speak about how you think the mindset, your mindset is going to be different than your brother's was, as you're the champion and they, you know, they were the challenger? How does that help you?
I can only hear at the very end of your story.
I'll say it one more time. How will your mindset be different going into this fight as an underdog, as the champion, you know, knowing that you're the champion, whereas your brothers were the challengers?
No, my mindset with that is, I always know, you know, it's the arguments over the, you know, the ring walks and things like that. You know, I'm not stupid. I know on paper I'm the B side of this fight. You know, Canelo's a big name. This show is, you know, Canelo's homecoming, Canelo's Mexican Independence Day. So mm-hmm. I'm not stupid like that, but I am the champion, and just switching back on that, that is one reason why I hope the judges respect that I'm champion and be, you know, be fair. If I win the fight, then make sure, you know, I get the decision. Give me the respect I deserve. I am the champion, even though I'm the, you know, the B side of the fight, Canelo's the big name, but I'm the champion going in. So, you know, this fight, you know, I know I am the champion, but this doesn't have to be a belt on the line for me. I've took this fight. I'm not in a situation where I have nothing to lose in this. I do have something to lose. I've got a title to lose. So it shows you the method behind me taking this fight. I'm taking this fight because it's an opportunity to make a name for myself and, you know, establish myself as the best 154-pounder in the world.
Now, lastly, you know, you feel this is the kind of fight that you've been, you know, training for your whole life, the kind of fight that, you know, makes you, turns you into a, you know, a name in Britain, to a star worldwide? Could you hear that? Or?
Sorry, no, I couldn't hear it, no.
Sorry. Do you see this as the kind of fight that you've been, you know, training for your whole life, that, you know, the kind of fight that could turn you in from a domestic, you know, world champion, a domestic name in England, to a worldwide star?
Yes, I do. This is a fight if I could pick a style of fight, I think it's similar to Canelo's style. I always wanted the Canelo fight, the Cotto fight. You know, a style like that is what I prefer to fight, I think. You know, and this fight can only be a great fight. There's no way the styles will make a bad fight. You know, this has got to gel well. This is a fight that, again, you're going to see me smiling in. Because, you know, even I'll smile when it's not going my way. I'm not going to not smile because I'm not having my own way. I'll smile because I'm going to enjoy every minute of this fight. This is, you know, I say to Joe every time we're in the gym, you know, this fight would light up my street, and it's a saying I use, and I just think it fits with Canelo. This fight is light up my street, style-wise. It's going to be, you know, give and take. You know, Canelo's going to have his moments. I'm not saying he's not, but I'm going to have my moments, and it will come down to who can finish off their moments and finish the fight the best. So, no, it's one that I'm looking forward to. Every time I think about the fight, it gets me excited. It just gets me excited. So it's one that I can't wait, and I really do, you know, think the fans are in for a great fight.
Thank you. Our next question comes from Salvador Rodriguez from ESPN Deportes. Please go ahead.
Hello, everybody. Eric, ¿me podrías ayudar con un par de preguntas para Liam? Primero, si él cree que sus oportunidades de triunfo ante Canelo son mucho más grandes de las que tiene Kell Brook ante Gennady Golovkin. Primero.
Okay, so Liam, I'll translate for you, Liam. This is Eric Gomez. The question was, do you liken your chances better than Brook against Triple G? Do you like your chances better against Canelo?
Yes, 100%. I like my chances, because to that I can only say 100%. I'm 100% confident of going in and winning this fight. The Cowboys won. I favour Triple G to win the fight. I hope Kell Brook wins the fight, and you know, I'll be rooting for Kell Brook, but I think it's a step too far for him, where I don't think it's a step too far for myself. So, yes, I think I've got the better chance.
But, Liam's a natural 154-pound fighter. He's not going up a weight. This is his weight. This is the weight he fights at.
Yes. Okay. Dice que sí, Chava, dice que sí, que obviamente para él es más grande, está peleando en su peso natural, él no está subiendo de peso o bajando, entonces él dice que sí, que ojalá pueda ganar Brook, que le vaya muy bien, ojalá, pero él está subiendo dos divisiones, pero en esta pelea con Canelo, él naturalmente es un 154 y va a pelear en su peso. Entonces él dice que sí, obviamente él tiene mejores posibilidades.
Por último, vi en el especial de HBO que habla mucho del autismo de su hermana. ¿Qué tan importante es este escenario, este pay-per-view, para concientizar al mundo de la importancia de ayudar a la gente con autismo?
¿De su hermana?
Sí.
Yeah, so he said, you know, HBO has been publicizing about your sister and autism. How important is this fight for you and this pay-per-view to get the word out around the world about autism and to make everybody aware of autism?
Yeah, well, it's important to us and our family. You know, my sister is autistic. We try and publicize that as much as we can and raise awareness to autism. So, you know, it's great for us that now the American fight fans and the American fans on HBO can also relate to that and can see, you know, we autism is a big thing, and my sister's severely autistic, so, you know, she's a massive inspiration to me and my brothers and obviously my parents as well.
Okay. Dice que sí, que obviamente es importante y es bonito que el mundo se dé cuenta. La pelea es acá en Estados Unidos, pero se va a ver por todas partes del mundo y que es algo muy especial para él, porque es una lucha y es una de las cosas que él está peleando por eso. Entonces, que es algo muy bueno y hay algo muy personal para él.
Muchas gracias. Thank you, everybody.
Thank you. Thank you, Chava.
Thank you. Our next question comes from Bernard Fernandez from the Sweet Science. Please go ahead.
Yeah, the questions that I was going to ask Liam have already been asked, but I have a question for Eric Gomez and two for Frank Warren.
Yeah.
Eric, Oscar has predicted a crowd of in the vicinity of 80,000 people. The two other fight cards that have been held at the Cowboys Stadium, AT&T Stadium, were involving Manny Pacquiao. One was 40,000, another 50,000. Vasquez's projection is correct. You'd have to sell 55,000 seats in the next 2 weeks. How close to that do you think that this fight can realistically approach?
I mean, look, there's a reason why Oscar's been very successful at promoting. And that's, you know, that's obviously that's our wish, that it can be a sellout. But I can say this, it's going to be a successful night already. And this is coming from the people with the Dallas Cowboys. Already, it's at this point, this far out from the fight, we've already surpassed Manny Pacquiao where he was at for his both fights. So the tickets are moving. They're moving steadily. And, you know, we feel that it's going to be a big crowd. It's going to look great. It's a big, beautiful stadium. We'll see. You never know. I mean, with the walk-up, a lot of the Mexican fans, they cross the border and they'll drive to Dallas for a lot of the Cowboy games. And from what, you know, they're telling us is they like to buy tickets from the box office. So we're expecting a big walk-up. Tickets are moving well. Well, I mean, we'll see. We'll see. We'll cross our fingers and hopefully we get there. But nevertheless, already with over 25,000 people, it's going to look great.
Okay, for Frank, England or Great Britain has always had an important role in the history of professional boxing. But, you know, per capita, probably the most intense fight fans going now are in Germany and England. I think Ring Magazine, their list of champions and top 10 rated fighters, there are actually more now from the UK than from the United States. What explains this, like, a huge spike, if it is indeed a huge spike, in popularity in boxing in the UK?
Well, it's always been a very popular sport here, Pedro. It's one of our main sports. And I think the main thing about it is because we're good at it. You know, we work. We not just me, other promoters, we've invested our time and our money over the years developing talent. And the bottom line is we do have good quality talent to come through. And Liam is, as I say, he's been a pro now for 8 years, and it's been a bit of a journey for him. And I know, and I don't mean it disrespectfully, in the early days, I just felt some of the fights that we were making were like making time fights. You see a fighter fighting, and you think to yourself, he needs to be stepped up and stepped up. And that's what we tried to do with him. And I think that what has happened, he's one of those special group of fighters. I mean, you know, we've got a lot of guys over here hold titles, but there's only about three or four of them who I think are real, what I call quality world champions, and he is one of them. And as I say, we've been very successful in what we do in boxing. And I think, you know, looking at the even if you look at the Olympic Games, we've had a great run there. You look at the heavyweight division over the last four or five Olympic Games, we've won medals where the US hasn't won medals at that weight. And I just think that with our guys, we've got a great most of them have great followings in their hometowns. We build them in their hometown. We don't four wall deals. You know, what we do is to try and build a following in their home cities, and I think that's what we're successful in doing, and that translates into interest in the fighters and the fact that the fighters want to box. There are guys out there, you know, in our amateur clubs, there are a huge amount of amateur boxing clubs in the UK, and they're very, very well supported and very well funded. And as I say, we've got a good system that's working, and you see that all translated now into what you're saying, the amount of British boxers that are in the ratings or are world champions. But I think for Liam, because obviously that's what this call is all about today, I think with Liam you're going to see something special. He has got something to lose. You know, people say they go to America, what have I got to lose? I'll go out there, I'm going to get a payday and that's it. But he's got something to lose, and it's something that I know that is very special to him, and that's his pride. And he's going there to win. He's going there to defend his title and come back with all the accolades that he's going to deserve in doing so. And, you know, and I'm not coming out there with him to sit there to go home as a loser. I'm coming out there because I've got belief, tremendous belief in him and tremendous belief in his preparation and what Joe Gallagher's doing with him, that he can come away winning this fight. It's not going to be easy. He's fighting a very good fighter. But you know what? He's got the tools to do it.
Okay, one last question. I guess this could be, you know, for Liam and for you, Frank. and that is that human nature being what it is. I mean, since so many people are pointing or looking forward to a mega fight between Triple G and Canelo, with Triple G fighting Kell Brook over in England and this fight here, some people are going to say, well, gee, you know, they're going to take the safe approach because they want to protect that. Human nature being this, how much of a motivating factor is that, you know, like a slap to a guy's pride, you know, that, you know, most people think that this is just going to be, you know, walk through the park, you know, because we got to protect the big fight. How motivating is that for Liam?
Well, Liam, do you mind first or Liam? Okay, right. Well, as I've just said, Pedro, he's very proud fighter and he's a very confident fighter. You know what they may feel they're safe fights, but let me tell you something: the fighters they're fighting are not coming to make up the numbers. They're coming to fight. You know, I used to promote Kell Brook. I got him up to the number one position. He had 20 fights with me. You know, he's a capable fighter. I think he's got a very, very tough fight. He's coming up two weight divisions to fight one of the best fighters, if not the best fighter in the world. And you've got Liam going into the guy who's also considered to be one of the best, if not the best, American fighters, or Mexican fighters. They are not frightened to step up to the plate. You can't be what people may be assuming and what they're saying about Canelo and Triple G cannot be said about either of the British boxers. They're stepping up. They're fearless. They're coming to fight. And my man, Liam, coming to the other guy's backyard. He's coming to the backyard, and I think down it, not to make up the numbers, to defend his title and come back as a winner. And then hopefully Liam Smith's name will be on everybody's list. If he wins this fight, and I really do feel, you know, as I say, it's not going to be easy, but I do feel that he has the capabilities to win it. It will be, in my opinion, one of the biggest upsets as far as Brits going abroad, as far as the press are going to be concerned. It'll be the biggest feat of a British boxer in modern times to go out there and do that. To me, that's how significant this fight will be. And that's why we're in there. That's why we've taken the fight, because we believe in our man. We believe in Liam Smith.
Well, thank you, Frank. Thank you, Eric. And thank you, Liam. Appreciate it.
Thank you.
Great. Thank you, Bernard.
Thank you.
Thank you. And once again, if you would like to ask a question, please press star, then one on your touch-tone phone. Our next question comes from Keith Idek from The Record. Please go ahead.
Yes, this question is for Frank and for Liam. If you could just explain why you guys withdrew from the drug testing and why that was important for you to do that.
Sorry, say that again.
No, they didn't. They didn't. I can talk to that, Frank, if you don't mind. They didn't withdraw. What we decided was we weren't going to do voluntary testing with VADA. But Liam is still undergoing testing by the British Boxing Control Board, and we're undergoing, Canelo's undergoing testing by Texas and the WBO. So nobody withdrew. There is testing.
Oh, okay, so there's a misconception out there that he withdrew.
There is. The British Boxing Board controls drug testing, and you may think I'm biased, but it's probably the most stringent of any governing body in the world, I can assure you. So, you know, from our end, we're happy with all the arrangements.
Great. Thank you very much, guys.
Thank you.
Thank you. Our next question comes from Hector Franco. Please go ahead. From Front Proof Media.
Hey, you guys. Thank you so much for taking our questions today. I just have one for Liam here today. You know, this is your first fight outside of the U.S. I just wanted to know, what kind of changes have you guys made in the training camp, if any? And, you know, there's been videos circulating out there of you sparring with Kell Brook. Has, you know, you guys made any changes to this particular training camp, or has this been, you know, kind of the same that you've been doing for the last few years?
Hi, it's kind of the same. You know, we've changed. The basically change in every camp. We've changed, obviously, sparring partners. We've changed you know, Padres, the joke. You change the combinations to, you know, offensively and defensively. We're working on what we think Canelo did well. So we just changed the, you know, the little adjustments we've done. The same to get conditioned well. You know, we always get conditioned well. We'll be fit and ready to fight. So, you know, there's no question about that. So we just changed the, like I said, the little adjustments to get ready towards Canelo.
Okay, and do you guys feel that, you know, coming up after, you know, this fight, if you guys come up victorious, are you guys looking at possibly unifying the division, or do you feel like after you defeat Canelo that a possible step up to middleweight is something that you'd be looking at in your future?
Look, no, I'm not a middleweight fan. You know, until my body's ready to go to middleweight, then I'll announce it. But, you know, I'm not going to sound like Canelo and sound like, you know, all the other people now and say, when I beat Canelo, I want to fight Charlo or I want to fight Triple G, because that is what we're criticizing Canelo for. Now, obviously, you know, my mind is just set on Canelo, and when I beat Canelo, my next fight will be Canelo again, because I know they will throw everything at. He overlooked me. He struggled with weight. And I know after September 17th, the excuses are going to come. So, you know, I know they're going to do what they can to get the rematch again. So, you know, my mind's focused on Canelo, and then it will be on Canelo again because, you know, like I say, I can see what's going to happen.
All right. Thank you so much, Liam. I appreciate your time.
Thank you.
No problem. Thank you.
Our next question comes from Mitch Abramson from RingTV.com. Please go ahead.
Hi, thanks. I have a question for Frank. Hey, Frank, are you there?
Yeah, I'm here.
Hey, thanks. Frank, what's going on with Billy Joe Saunders? I know there was talk about him possibly being on his undercard. He's not going to be on the undercard.
We're announcing his fight on Monday, next Monday.
Okay, and is there, again, there was some talk about possibly in December with Billy Joe fighting Canelo if Canelo is successful. Is that, again, I know you have to get by Liam Smith, but is that still a possibility in your eyes?
No, it's not. It's not a possibility because Liam Smith is going to win this fight.
Okay.
Thank you.
Thanks.
That's a great answer, Frank.
That's what it is.
It's the truth.
That's what we're there for. We're not there to lose.
I mean, Frank, you know, in the event that some miracle happens and Liam does not win, I mean, would that be still in play between Canelo and Saunders?
Well, I've got to tell you, Frank, if he doesn't win, it's gonna. If he doesn't, and I'm not, and I'm very positive on this. But if he wasn't to win, all I know is everybody will be demanding a rematch because this is going to be a great fight. Whatever happens, you're going to want to. If he loses, which I don't think he will, then you'll want to see the rematch.
Okay. Do you want, and last thing, Frank? Do you want to reveal who Saunders is fighting next?
No, we'll talk about that on Monday.
Paul Saunders.
Let's deal with our man on the. Let's deal with my champion here, Liam Smith. That's all we're at the moment focused on. All will be revealed with Billy Joe on Monday. And if you wish to participate in the press conference or on the call, please speak to Dan in the office, and we'll give you the heads up just before.
Okay, thanks. Best of luck, guys.
Thank you.
Thank you. Our next question comes from Carlos Flores from Record Newspaper. Please, once again. It looks like you dropped it. Carlos, if you have a question, please press star then one. And he seems to have dropped. Please proceed.
Okay, thank you so much, Christine. And this is Cecilia. I think we're all ready for final comments. Frank, do you have any final comments to the press still on the line?
No, all I would say, I hope that we do sell the stadium out because I want to see, because the Mexican people are great, great boxing fans. And I want them to be there to see what I believe one of our great British boxers. Because they're going to love him. They're going to love what he does. They're going to love what they see. Don't miss this. This is a fight to be there and see it. This is going to, I think it's going to be a history-making fight for a British fighter.
Thank you so much, Frank. Joe Gallagher, are you still on the line?
Yeah, I'm Love, yes.
Would you like to make some final comments?
Yeah, just that Liam Smith's coming over very well prepared, ready to defend his title. And on Sunday, the 18th, let's not be talking about three dodgy judges, and let's talk about a good world champion in Liam Smith, and that's my only fear for this fight. You've got two honest fighters putting their careers and their lives on the line, and we need three honest men sat around the ringside and to score the fight correctly. What we don't want to have a bad decision. We've seen the corruption with the Olympics of late, the bad judging and the bad scoring, and this can't happen. It's Mexican Independence Weekend. Liam Smith's going out there. He's putting his title on the line, his life on the line, and we need three honest men to go home that night and go to bed thinking, I did the right thing, and by doing the right thing, they'll score Liam Smith the winner.
Thank you so much, Joe. Liam, go ahead and say your final comments.
Yes, just thanks for everyone, obviously, for calling with the questions. Like Joe and Frank said, we're coming September 17th. They're dead. We'll have no excuses. And, you know, I hope to speak to all the same people on September the 18th and, you know, just say, I told you so. And thanks to the champion. So, also like to say thanks, obviously, Joe. And Frank and Eric and all the, you know, the Golden Boot stars for making this fight with you. And I'll, you know, remember thanking them, you know, 10 weeks ago. Now the fight's 2 weeks away. So, you know, thanks. And I hope you have a great show for the same thing.
Thank you so much, Liam. Eric, we're ready for your final comments.
Great. So thank you, guys. Thank you once again, Frank Warren. Frank's been a great partner with us and, by far the best promoter in the UK. And, you know, Joe Gallagher obviously is the top trainer. Liam is an undefeated fighter. This is a great fight, a dangerous fight. Styles make fights. This is going to be an explosive fight. We're very excited for this fight. Don't miss the HBO pay-per-view, or you can go in person and see it at the beautiful AT&T Stadium, home of Dallas Cowboys. Again, tickets are still available. You can get tickets at Ticketmaster, www.ticketmaster.com. Again, I want to thank the sponsors, everybody involved. Thank you very much, and thank you for being on the call, media.
Thank you, Eric. Thank you, guys. Thank you very much.
Cheers, Eric.
Cheers, mate.
Thank you, and thank you, ladies and gentlemen. This concludes today's conference. Thank you for participating. You may now disconnect.